This video's for curry.grfx. And to all the other people that have requested a video from weeks ago, don't think that I forgot your request. The video's on the way, and I'm working on it. And if you have suggestions on what video you want me to do, tell me in the comment section, and I'll write it down on a sheet of paper in order, just so that I don't forget. And if you are new to my channel and not subscribed, make sure to subscribe, because I drop basketball videos and I cover different topics of the NBA. And don't forget to hit the notification button to get notified whenever I drop a video, if you are subscribed already. And before I start this video, I'd like to say very close friends of mine created an Instagram page to raise awareness about Alzheimer's disease. So if you are a person that is suffering from the disease or know someone that is, don't be afraid to follow their Instagram page, Fight Against AD, or to share yours or someone else's story. And like I always say, once again, it's Third Eye V195 coming at you with another video. Stay tuned.
Sell it for free. Put no prices on that body. Sell it for free. Ayy, sell it for free. Girl, you know that body price is sell it for free.
Marcin Gortat was drafted in the second round at 57 by the Phoenix Suns back in the 2005 NBA draft. But with his rights, he was traded to the Orlando Magic. But he decided not to play in the NBA. He decided to keep playing in Germany until the year 2007. On August the 2nd, back in 2007, Marcin would sign with the Orlando Magic. But on November the 20th, back in 2007, he was sent to the Development League, which stands for Gatorade League now. At the time he was playing in the Development League, he was playing with a team called Anaheim Arsenals. But the Anaheim Arsenals are no longer in existence, because the name was changed to Springfield Armor in 2009, when the team moved to Springfield, Massachusetts. And the team's name was changed again, and now stands for Grand Rapids Drive, which is the G League team that's affiliated with the Detroit Pistons since 2014. Gortat would make his first NBA debut with the Orlando Magic back on March the 1st in 2008. Against the New York Knicks, because he was in the D League and not getting any playing time for a few months, as you can see. But unfortunately, he played really bad. He only had 2 points and he got one personal foul. But to his defense, he only played for 2 minutes. But the good thing is, the Magic won that game against the Knicks 118-92. He played a couple more times during the month of March, but he wasn't productive at all, and he was getting really bad minutes until the last regular season game on April the 16th against the Washington Wizards. He played for 28 minutes and he got his first double-double in his career. He scored 12 points and grabbed 11 rebounds, including one steal, one block, and he dished out 2 assists. The Magic would go on to win that game against the Wizards 103-83. In Gortat's rookie season, in just 6 games, he was only able to average 3 points and 2.7 rebounds because he spent so much time in the D League. The Orlando Magic were able to make it to the playoffs back in 2008, but the Magic would go on to lose to the Detroit Pistons in the conference semifinals in 5 games. And in 8 games of the playoffs, Gortat was only able to average 1.3 points and 1 rebound. In Gortat's sophomore season, he would play more minutes and he improved statistically from his rookie season. He averaged 3.8 points and 4.5 rebounds, playing 12.6 minutes per game. The reason why he wasn't doing better statistically and getting more playing time is because he was the backup center behind Dwight Howard, but he never failed to show he has the potential to be a starting center in this league during the season and in the playoffs. Because on December the 15th, back in 2008, he started at the center position because Dwight Howard was injured, and Gortat played for 28 minutes against the Golden State Warriors, and he scored 16 points and grabbed 13 rebounds, including 3 blocks, and he dished out 1 assist. And the Magic went on to win that game 109-98. And then on April the 13th, back in 2009, he would start again over Dwight Howard against the Milwaukee Bucks, and Gortat scored 10 points and grabbed a career high at the time, 18 rebounds, including 1 steal, 1 block, and he dished out 2 assists. But unfortunately, the Magic would go on to lose that game 98-80. Then in the playoffs on April the 30th, back in 2009, Gortat would start for the first time in the playoffs in his career against the Philadelphia 76ers, because Dwight Howard was suspended because of something that he did in game 5 of that series. And Gortat showed up. He scored 11 points and grabbed 15 rebounds, including 4 steals, and he dished out 2 assists. And the Magic would go on to win that game 114-89 and advance to the conference semifinals. And in the 2009 playoffs, the Magic would go on to advance to the NBA Finals, where they would lose to the Lakers in 5 games. Gortat also became the first Polish-born player to ever appear in the NBA Finals in NBA history. And throughout 24 games in the 2009 playoffs, he averaged 3.3 points and 3.2 rebounds, playing 11.3 minutes. During the 2009 NBA offseason, Gortat was a restricted free agent, and he signed an offer sheet for 5 years worth $34 million with the Dallas Mavericks, but the Magic would decide to match the offer sheet 5 days later on July the 13th. But Gortat was mad about it because he didn't want to stay in Orlando to play as a backup center. He wanted to be a starter, and he knew that would happen if he ended up on the Mavericks. In the 2009-10 season, Gortat's stats would dip in the regular season and in the playoffs from his sophomore season, even though he got a little bit more minutes. As you can see, Gortat's time would come to an end with the Magic on December the 10th back in 2010 because he was traded to the Phoenix Suns, including Vince Carter, Michael Petras, and the first round draft pick, which became Nikola Mirotic, including $3 million. And in exchange, the Orlando Magic got Jason Richardson and Earl Clark and Hito Turkoglu. In 25 games with the Magic that season before being traded, he played the most minutes he's ever played since his rookie season, playing 15.8 minutes, and he scored the most points, averaging 4 points, and he averaged the most rebounds as well, with 4.7 rebounds. Even though Gortat wasn't a starter when he just arrived in Phoenix, he still played solid in 55 games with the Suns. He started in only 12 games, and he averaged 13 points, 1.3 blocks, and 1 assist. In his second year with the Suns, he proved that he can be a solid starting center in this league. He averaged a career high in points, and he started all of the 66 games that he played that season, because remember, the 2011-12 season was a shortened season because of the lockout in the beginning of that season, which is why he never played 82 games. He averaged 15.4 points, 1.5 blocks, and 10 rebounds, which was the first time that he averaged a double-double in his career in a season. In his third year with the Suns, he would dip statistically, but he still played pretty solid. But his time in Phoenix would come to an end on October the 25th, back in 2013, because he was traded, including Shannon Brown, Malcolm Lee, and Kendall Marshall, to the Washington Wizards, and in return, the Suns got Omeka Okafor and a 2014 protected first-round draft pick. Gortat would continue to play solid in Washington and in the playoffs as well, where he would have his best playoff performances in his career. Now, if you look at the 2016-17 season and compare it to this past season, you'll notice that his stats dropped in the regular season and in the playoffs as well. So the question is, what's happening to Marcin Gortat? And the answer is that he got less minutes and he wasn't on good terms with John Wall. And when you are not on good terms with your point guard, a person that runs the offense, it's not good because it can affect you as a big man. It was said that Gortat was mad at John Wall because of his selfishness as a teammate on defense. Stephen A. Smith reported on the situation and he said Gortat had a real big time issue with John Wall as teammates with the Washington Wizards. Scott Brooks constantly allowing folks to switch all the time instead of manning up and forcing them to guard folks, because Scott Brooks is known for not liking confrontation, basically took heat off individual players by allowing switches to take place every second. As a result, because John Wall wasn't considered somebody too eager to guard anybody, Gortat found himself in the precarious situations of having to guard guards, quicker, smaller players. He's older, clearly devoid of the lateral movement that will enable him to guard guys, was lamenting the fact that he was put in bad situations by John Wall's lack of defense, said so in a team meeting. John Wall turned around and MF'd him to death. From that moment forward, Gortat wanted out of Washington. Also, Gortat tweeted something saying, "Unbelievable win tonight. Great quote, team victory." And John Wall tweeted back at him saying, "LOL," apparently indicating that John Wall is a selfish teammate. And this is what John Wall had to say after that tweet.
"10 assists a game. I'm very prideful and finding my teammates and getting these guys in these shots. And it was more just shocking to hear from him and understanding that he gets the most assists for me and the most spoon-fed baskets ever.
And after the Washington Wizards lost to the Raptors in 6 games this past playoffs, John Wall came out and said the Wizards need to upgrade from Marcin Gortat and Ian Mahimi. So as you can see, this is what has been affecting Gortat's game lately, and there's no denying that. But Gortat's in a better place now because he was traded from the Wizards to the LA Clippers for Austin Rivers. So hopefully things work out for him in LA, because I feel like he can still be a double-double machine. But that's what's happening to Marcin Gortat. But that's it for the video, guys. And like I always say, please like and subscribe and hit that notification button and comment below. Tell me what you think. Your opinion matters. And follow me on my Twitter and Instagram account. It's the same name as my YouTube channel name. And share this video. Peace.
I eat my French toast bag of French girl. Tell her, let's go. Watch me explode like I'm Mentos mixed with that coke. Moving like a groupie, so I back up pronto. Though you a baddie, I'ma split my Uber, go get you a text.